السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأصلي وأسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله ما بعد لنصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. أوكي. Now we'll start the, we'll continue some of the hadith. The second book is about the hadith. Yes, we reached to hadith. Yes, sir. Anyone is using the book? No one? Alhamdulillah. Mafi? We don't have good student? One, at least one good student. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. He has not. All of you good students, inshallah. طيب. حديث النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام يسروا ولا تعسروا وبشروا ولا تنفروا. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, make things easy and don't make them difficult. Cheer the people up by conveying glad tidings to them and don't repulse them. طيب. Of course, this is one of the main ahadith in Islam, one of the main concepts in Islam. How many minutes we have, Abu Zakaria? Half an hour? 1 hour? 2 hours? Up to Fajr? Tamam Allah. I think now you got a message, huh? طيب. Tell me when to stop, tell me, huh? So this is one of the main concepts in Islam. Yeah, to make the things easy. If it is possible to make it easy. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ما خير بين شيئين. Whenever the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had the option, okay, between two things, he will choose the easier. If it is not haram, he will choose the easier. طيب. And this is very important. Many people, many Muslims, when they read the hadith, it means use the haram. No, the يعني for example, I am sick. Okay, and I am in the hospital after operation, or I have something difficult. Okay, so you say, no, alhamdulillah, Islam is easy. Don't pray. When you discharge, you can pray all of them to make it easy. No, this is wrong concept. Okay, what is the correct concept? In Islam, Allah likes the ease. So you cannot stand up. Okay, sit down and pray. This is the meaning of yassiru, make the things easy. Well, I cannot sit down. Khalas, on bed. I cannot make wudu, make tayammum. Alhamdulillah. So this is the meaning of make the things easy. Make the things easy. Okay. For example, we are a group. And we want to pray al-isha, for example. We are in a camp. Okay. Or we are traveling. We want to pray. Which prayer? Al-Isha. Okay. Al-Isha, it's better to delay Al-Isha. For example, the Adhan 6:30. It's better to pray, for example, 9:30. Okay. But if we delay up to 9:30, it means we need to stop again. So make jam. Make jam. Maghrib. Join Maghrib with, join Al-Isha with Maghrib. Or for example, pray Al-Isha early. 6:30. Khalas, pray 6:35. So try to make the things easy for people. Don't make the things difficult for them. If it is possible. If it is possible. I mean, if it is not haram. Again, if it is not haram. So the Prophet ﷺ said, يَسِّرُوا وَلَا تُعَسِّرُوا. Make the things easy and don't make them difficult. This is the Muslim. This is the Muslim. The Prophet ﷺ saw a man and the other companions surrounding him. So what's the problem? They said, Rasulullah, Israel, his name is Israel, okay? He made a vow to fast, نذر أن يصوم ويقف ولا يجلس ولا يستظل. He made a vow to fast and to stand up and to be and not to to stand up under a madalla, under a shade. Okay. What is the word to be direct to the sun? Light?
Under the sun.
Under the sun? Okay. In Arabic it is ضاحي. ضاحي means يعني directly under the sun. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, tell him to fast, sit, and to be under the shade. Fasting is good. Okay, standing up. Good or bad? No, no need for it. It is not a worship. It is not a worship. Oh Allah, I make a vow to stand up 2 hours. No, it is not a worship. Oh Allah, I'm giving a vow not to stay under the shade for 1 hour. It is not a worship. Okay, fasting? No, fasting is okay. Fasting, it is a kind of worship. One of the best kinds of worship. So the Prophet ﷺ said, tell him to fast, to continue fasting, but to sit down and to sit down under a shade. So this is the meaning of the hadith, yassiru, make the things easy. وَلَا تُعَسِّرُ. Then the Prophet ﷺ said, وَبَشِّرُوا وَلَا تُنَفِّرُوا. And sorry, yani about to make the things easy. Many times I mentioned this hadith. A man had a wound in his head. Then he asked his companions, his friends, I have to take shower because of ghusl. Yani he made something. Then ghusl is compulsory. Taking shower is compulsory. And I have a wound in my head. What should I do? They said, you have to make ghusl. You have to take shower. You have to wash the whole body. No excuse. Then he made the he took the shower. Then he died. Okay. The Prophet ﷺ said, "Why they did this? He should make tayammum and that's it. Tayammum means the dry ablution, and it's enough for him. Subhanallah. So Islam is easy. Why you are doing this?" Then he said, "Wabashiru wa la tunaffiru. Wabashiru." It means conveying glad tidings. Okay, so this is the way in Islam. Try to tell the people the good things. Okay, yani not always, but most of the time. Okay, try if there is chance, tell the people the good things. Make yani give some hope for the Muslims. Only talk about the bad things. Wallahi, the Muslim Ummah now is very bad. Our leaders, our rulers, our scholars, and our children, our wives, our husbands. Habibi, why? Yeah, and you are depressed and you want everyone to be depressed? Yeah, say something good. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من قال هلك الناس فهو أهلكهم. من قال هلك الناس فهو أهلكهم. The one who says, هلك الناس وإن هلك الناس يعني خلاص. All the people are doomed. يعني, now all of them are bad. All of them are bad. All of them are spoiled. خربوطه in Kuwait. Okay. Then the Prophet said, then فهو أهلكهم, he is the worst. Or another meaning, فهو أهلكهم, it means they are bad because of him. Okay, this is a good point. Okay, what is the meaning of this point? Yeah, suppose that every day I have a lecture, and all of my lectures, I'm saying maybe half of the lecture or half an hour, I'm saying, brothers, sisters, nowadays our leaders, our teachers, our children, our mothers, our fathers, okay, they are doing this mistake. Look, the street, it is crowded, and they don't respect the traffic rules, and they our toilets are dirty, and the students. So imagine every day, half an hour, I am telling only about the negative points. What will happen? خلاص, your mind will be full of negativity. You'll think very bad about the community. Okay. This is, subhanAllah, this is the way of some da'iyah, some teachers, some scholars. This is their way. When you attend their lectures, a'udhu billah, you feel very bad. After the lecture, You hate everyone. Even you hate your family. Why? Because all of their statements are negative. They are not saying anything good. Subhanallah. No. The way of the Prophet ﷺ try to... يعني, we mentioned the brothers who attended last Tuesday's lecture. We mentioned the hadith when the Prophet ﷺ said he got a piece of cloth. Then he said, where is Khalid? Khalid, one of the girls. They brought this girl and it was a plain dress. Except for one place, there is a different color. يعني, suppose it is gray, but only for this piece it is red or red and white. So the Prophet ﷺ said, هذا سنة. This place or this color, huh? This patch makes the whole dress nice. يعني, the Prophet ﷺ focused on the nice part. It is smaller. It is dot. Or it is only 2% of the whole dress. But the Prophet ﷺ focused on the good points. Why you are focusing on the bad points? Please try to mention the good points in the Muslim Ummah. Okay, you have, for example, nowadays, people, not only nowadays, long years back, there are people, many people speak very bad about Saudi Arabia. Look, they bring the people who are singing, dancing, and a lot of sins, music. Okay, and they gave the permission for ladies to drive the car. So, for those people who don't know Saudi or they are far, they think now, if I go to Saudi Arabia, it is a casino. But the fact, when you visit there, alhamdulillah, at the time of Adhan, you hear all the masajid giving the Adhan, and you see the Muslims going to the masjid. And if you go to Mecca, mashallah, 24 hours it is open. And people doing tawaf all the time. Medina, the masjid is open 24 hours. You go to the masajid, people memorize the Quran. If you go to the faculty of Sharia, mashallah, you'll find many students in Riyadh, in Medina, in Mecca. Alhamdulillah, they do not close the faculty of Sharia. Okay, why you are not talking about the good things? Only talk about, wallah, in Jeddah there is a party and they invited one lady, a non-Muslim lady, dancing in front of. Okay, yani, no doubt, music is haram. In Mecca, in Saudi, in Kuwait, in US, music is haram. Okay, and everyone knows this is haram and this is wrong. Okay, but why you are magnifying these mistakes? Is it okay, I mean, is it useful to talk about these mistakes or not? Okay, the point is, your point is to make people hate Saudi and Saudi people. Still, alhamdulillah, when you go to Saudi, alhamdulillah, most of the ladies with niqab, with hijab, alhamdulillah. Every year I go to Saudi and I see, the issue is totally different than what is mentioned in the media. And you go there and you can't find. But usually, subhanallah, the evil people, they try to make the haram things much, much bigger than the fact. Again, I don't mean that the haram is halal. A'udhu billah. The haram still is haram. In Kuwait, in Saudi, in Makkah, anywhere. The haram is haram. But the point is, don't focus on the wrong mistakes. I mean the mistakes. And to make them as the main thing. And you, people think that all the people in Saudi went to the party. Still, wallahi, alhamdulillah, many Saudi people, they pray the five prayers. They go to the Jum'ah prayer maybe 5 hours before the Jum'ah. 5 hours. Go to the masajid or some of the masajid before the Jum'ah, 2-3 hours. You'll find people reciting Quran. Alhamdulillah. In Ramadan, some masajid full. Why the people are not mentioning these points? Okay. So this is very important. Bashiru. Glad tidings. وَلَا تُنَفِّرُوا وَلَا تُنَفِّرُوا. What is the meaning, وَلَا تُنَفِّرُوا? Don't make people hate Islam. And the famous hadith, in this point, the Prophet ﷺ, Mu'adh ibn Jabal used to pray with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which salah? Isha. Then he goes to his village, leading them. Why? Because he's a scholar. He's one of the scholars. He has more Quran. So he was leading the salah. So the first salah is fard for him. But the second salah is nafil, optional salah. It is not compulsory. So one day he started with Surah Al-Baqarah. Alif Lam Mim. ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين. Maybe you need 2 hours to recite Surah Al-Baqarah. So one of them left the jama'ah. He said, no, I am tired. I will not pray with the imam. Only one. Imagine. The rest of the people continued with Mu'adh. Can you imagine? Yeah, subhanAllah, please, brothers, sisters, try to reflect the hadith. All of them continued the salah with Mu'adh, except one. One did not agree with Mu'adh. He said, khalas, I will pray alone. I will continue alone. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Inna minkum munaffirin." Some people, okay, they are munaffirin, make others hate Islam. يعني, you are making the salah too long. Okay, please, what is the meaning of too long? It does mean 15 minutes, because people now, if the salah is 15 minutes, sometimes I lead the salah in our masjid. I'm working military hospital. So sometimes, or not sometimes, really, there is no imam or no muaddin. So I lead the salah. So usually, the imam of the masjid prays 6 minutes. Usually 6 minutes. So maybe when I lead the salah, maybe I took 7 minutes. Not more than 7 minutes. So after we finished the salah, my colleague said, "Huh, Sheikh Ahmed, you prayed too long, yani only 1 minute more. 1 minute more. And imagine, instead of 6 minutes, 7 minutes. So nowadays, subhanAllah, so what about if you pray 10 minutes? Oh, this is a disaster. If your Asr salah or Dhuhr salah, 10 minutes, خلاص, you will be killed. You will be in the jail. You will be kafir. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. So imagine, Mu'adh recited Surah Al-Baqarah, at least two hours. Okay? And how many people complain? One. Or how many people left the jama'ah? Only one. But imagine now, if you lead the salah, if you recite Surah Al-Baqarah, of course they will not give you the chance to continue. They will beat you during the salah. They will not give you the chance. Do you think that they will leave you? They will beat you. They will take you to the, they will call the police. They will call the police. Tal, we have a crazy imam now. He is reciting Surah Al-Baqarah in Isha Salah. He's a crazy. Please take him to the psychiatry hospital. I cannot imagine. Allah musta'an. So the point is, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, wala tunaffiru, don't make people to hate Islam. Don't make people to hate Islam. Of course, it doesn't mean that I do the haram to make people happy. But if there is a way to make people love Islam, attract them to Islam, do it. Okay?
Shaykh, on the other way, there is a hadith about one person who was blind, one of the Sahabi, he was blind. And he asked him to come in the house because he was blind, he was old. And you know, there was an issue, it was like dark in the road and there were scorpions. And he asked if I can pray in the house, and he was told that no, you will pray in the masjid. So this hadith of making things easy, it contradicts this point.
No, it is not contradicting. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him, "Can you hear Hayya ala sahiba? Can you hear the adhan? Hayya ala salah. Hayya." He said yes. He said yes. Answer. Why? Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam understood from his situation that it is possible. Yes, there is some difficulty, but it is possible. And attending the jama'ah is very important. Because if he prays at home alone, then this can lead, maybe with time, he will not pray. Or maybe another man will take the same excuse, and he will pray alone. This man, that man, the third, fourth, then at the end, no one in the masjid. Like nowadays, maybe 1,000 of people surrounding the masjid and only 20 people come to the masjid. What are they? Go, that's okay, it is not important to pray in the masjid. Then you find our masjid empty or almost empty. Jazakumullah khair.